like a cold one. You gon' be my only, only. I can see that you were wanting. I'ma make you fall in love. Just step back and watch me work, work, work.
MCOnAir.com. We are the Get Down. Happy Hump Day.
Hump day.
Y'all humping today?
No.
Oh, damn.
Does Hump Day really mean, like, have sex day?
No, ma'am.
You talking about Hump of the Week.
Right, you're getting over that hump of your work week.
Well, I don't like that. I rather like to have sex day.
I agree.
I'm gonna say, happy fuck day.
I'm with that all the way.
I'll buy that for a dollar.
Oh my gosh. All right. I am Pretty Ricky, and I hold the keys to Yo City, Yo City, City, and Yo City. City. You can follow me on Instagram, Vine, Facebook, and Twitter at Pretty Ricky, RICCI, Owen Shots. Yeah.
And I am Nene Nice, and I am like fire and ice. And you can follow me at Nene Nice, NaeNaeNice, Twitter, Instagram, Vine, Shots. And that's it for today.
Yo, okay. All right, yeah.
Christian Mingo.
Christian Mingo.
Yeah, we're waiting for
Farmers
Christian Mingo.
Only. I mean,
blackpeoplemeet.com.
Did you get rid of all of those?
Black Planet.
I have Black Planet too.
MySpace.
You can hit me on MySpace. I do have a new MySpace. MySpace is updated.
Oh,
God. I do have a new one. I haven't logged in though since the first time I created an account.
MySpace.
All right, and our DJ, DJ Punch.
Yeah, it's your boy DJ Punch, man. You guys can follow me at I am DJ Punch on Instagram, Twitter, and even on Facebook. You guys can look me up, DJ Punch.
All right, that's what's up. And our fall crew, at least half of
them. I'm going to make some noise.
Miss Erica.
You can find me on Instagram, Miss Erica, MissAirica. And you can maybe add me on Facebook, Erica Hartsfield, AirikaHartsfield.
All right, that's what's up. And shout out to our intern over there, A. Nicole.
Hey, Nicole!
And shout out to our producer extraordinaire, DJ Rock.
Rockalicious!
There's only one, it's like Fell Out Crew.
What?
Fell Out Crew.
Bye. We have one half of the Far Out Crew tonight.
You can follow me at my new Instagram, which is I am, or I be, DJ
get it
Rock.
Right, get it right. Start over. Clean slate. Go, right. Go.
You can follow me on my new Instagram at IBDJRock or Radio Free Rock at Facebook.
That voice is so...
I loved it.
You can follow our whole show at the Get Down _ on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Yeah, we have a lot of stuff going on, so you may want to follow us.
Follow.
Just saying. Got the chocolate and vanilla.
Twitter.
Just saying. Okay, so now it's time for shout outs. I would like to shout out Hustle Management, Jay Hustle, Pitbull Energy Drink for sponsoring the Get Down every Wednesday night at 10 p.m. Shout out to Armadale Vodka for living that top shelf life. Woo! And shout out to the fine ass. Oh, God. Woo! This fine ass swirl that I seen today.
Where?
Driving down the street.
Are you gonna like, you gonna hit up on Craigslist?
What?
You know that Craigslist?
I was thinking like she met, you know, a swirl or something. She's like driving down the street.
No, there's actually a Craigslist thing where you missed occasions or something like that. And you can put
I saw
you walking and you were a swirl. Hey. And holler back if you saw me
holler back.
And then
okay, let's shout out to the weirdos on Craigslist. Because have you guys seen them though?
I got
People actually have like casual encounters on Craigslist. They put pictures of their fucking dick up.
Oh yeah, I've seen them.
Like come get this shit. Meet me here. Da, da, da.
That means I gotta stay out there.
Shout out to y'all weird ass motherfuckers who are gonna go to jail.
Okay, that shit's gross. Why I gotta go to jail?
You're on their rock? That's sick.
It's not illegal.
I was bored.
You put a picture of your dick on there?
Well, his dick is already out there, okay?
I know that, but like, now you're asking, you give him your address too?
No, I take a picture of what I ate, like a foodie was actually, and then I take a picture of me.
But that's for Instagram.
He cracked himself up.
Okay.
Right.
We all like crickets. All right, any more shout outs tonight?
Yeah, shout out to Hustle's mama. Happy birthday to Mama Hustle.
Hey.
Mama Hustle. Party time, Mama Hustle.
I hope Hustle's turning up. We'll make it
turn it up on a Wednesday.
Got the show going up
on a Wednesday.
Any more shout outs tonight, guys?
No. Shout out to all the fine men that I will be finding you now since I'm single.
Oh, yeah, you're
shout
single.
Shout out
to Lowe's who hired me for a seasonal job.
Oh, that's what's up.
Shout out to Lowe's. We booked with Lowe's. I need a discount.
No, not shout out to Lowe's. I'm going to tell my story for the what's the shit called?
What?
Dust bag of the week.
Oh. Wait, so your dust bag has Lowe's?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Oh, is that right?
Definitely, yes.
Oh,
so.
Man.
All right, yeah.
Anybody else have shout out?
We're good? Okay, so let's go ahead and get into the show. Celebrity situations. All right, so Tiny, we all know that Tiny decided to go get a procedure done, and it was not her nose. I wish it was, but it wasn't. It was her eyes.
Piglet.
Okay. And when we first saw the picture of her eyes, they were gray. And people put out memes on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter saying that she looked like a pit bull.
That's so mean. They need to leave her alone.
A blue pit. Okay.
Oh, my God. That's so terrible.
So there's a picture.
There's a picture out. Ooh. What is that?
Your headphones?
They're down. They're turned all the way down.
Somebody's headphones.
Ooh, yeah. Right. You guys, let's get it together over there. All right. So, there is a picture out on Instagram right now that Tiny put of herself. And she's like made up, got makeup on, make sure she's accentuating her eyes. Like, what do you guys think about this? Now that we see a close-up. Because before, there wasn't a close-up like this. If you want to see the picture, it's on our Instagram, @thegetdown_, or it's on rmconair.com right now. Take a look at the picture, comment. What do you think? The eyes look blue now. They don't look gray anymore. They changed.
I think that I want mine done.
What?
I want some green eyes.
How do you do your eyes?
It's
you
a procedure.
And get them done.
So you can do them here. You can do them here. Well, yeah. No, it's the law hasn't passed here, so I guess
it's
passed
in. No,
it's
not here. It's like in like Africa.
So they inject your eyes or something?
I don't know what they do. But I'll stick the contacts.
I think they probably put like a contact in between it. They can slit your eyelid and put it in there, your eyeball, and slip it in there. That's the only way you can get it there.
Well, I don't know.
That's not cool.
I think that fucking with your eyes is like fucking with God, what God created. Like, weaves are one thing, nails are another thing.
Okay,
we can take
boobs
those out.
And like asses.
You can take your boobs out. Ass don't last long. Like, if it's an implant, it's like titties. You can get them taken out. But your eyes, like that's your DNA. Your booty and titties aren't your DNA. You know, like anything you go sign up for, like your driver's license or shit like that, they make sure that the eye color is on there. So if somebody's a killer running around here, the killer gonna go from green eyes to gray eyes? Like,
change your whole appearance.
Yeah.
I have blue eyes now.
That's scary that can be a possibility. Like,
face off.
I mean, you know what?
Right.
It was ready. It's been coming. Like, you can change everything else on your body. How come you can't change your eyes?
I don't know. I think that's just a little bit too much.
But you can't change your fingerprints.
No, well, we don't know.
Not yet.
Right.
Well, if you peel someone else's off and put them on your own.
You know what? I did see something where a guy actually, he murdered somebody, and they were going to take his DNA. So he took blood from somebody else, and he put a line in his arm. So when they went to go and take the blood, they would take someone else's blood and not his own.
Man.
Wow, it's serious out here in these streets, huh?
Yeah.
Serious, but... Of course they caught him because at the end of the day, the blood obviously is not running through your veins.
That's so like the whole...
It's like different.
The pregnancy test trick.
Looks different.
Like, or like the drug test trick. Like you go in the bathroom and you take somebody else's warm pee and a condom and you like put it on the test so it, theirs is clean because they don't do drugs and you do.
Yeah, that's the like, international rich.
Or you can just buy fake pee from the store.
That's the international rich.
No, it has to be warm because they do
the
temperature.
You can warm it. You can warm the fake pee.
Oh, that's gross.
And you just warm it, and then the guys just drop it to their dick and flip the thing open like that.
Yeah, that's gross. Actually a little tube you buy, and then it goes right here.
Yep.
Why? Even, but no, wait. Like sometimes they go in the bathroom with you.
Yeah, but it's matter. On your penis, though.
It's on the penis, and then you tape it on there, and it's a color flesh thing that matches your flesh, so it looks like it's coming out of your hole, but it's not, and the tube goes up.
And you just flick it, and you flick it, everything.
You
know, people be holding a little dick or whatever.
And you hold the penis, and you push a little button, and it comes out. All right, let's go.
All right, so.
Seems like Roxy's that one too many times.
Right, let's go.
So
I know you guys heard about Bill Cosby. If you have not heard about Bill Cosby, I mean, I just feel sorry for this old man because, like, there's these allegations coming out that he's pretty much a rapist that back in the day, like back in the late 70s, early 80s, that he used to drug women, like put something in their drinks, and that's it.
Okay, so my question is, why are these allegations just now coming out, and what is going on with all this?
Yeah, First of all, can I hear a music bed? I feel like I'm talking, like, over air.
Right.
Was the static coming from his thing just now? That's what it was.
Oh.
Got it. Okay.
If I pulled it down, because it was... I mean, would you rather hear that?
No.
I feel what you're saying. Okay, so number one, this was, what, 20 years ago? So people are just coming out now?
Man. Well, one lady came out, and all of a sudden now Janice Dickinson came out and said, like, oh, he did the same thing to me. And my thing is, like, this man is, like, got to be, like, in his 70s, 80s now. Like, why y'all, like, what? Why you didn't say nothing back then?
Is there statute of limitations to that, though?
That's right? I don't know.
I'm sure there is. There probably, well, I don't know. But... Janice Dickinson, you probably took those drugs yourself.
I wouldn't believe that bitch with a fucking 10-foot pole.
Right, not at all. No, sorry, honey. No.
Yeah, you're delusional. You've been high since you came out the pussy, so nobody fucking believes you.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm just saying.
That's real shit, though.
Like, so, do you guys believe that Bill Cosby, I know we don't know this man personally, but do you believe that Bill Cosby is capable of drugging women and raping them?
Yes, I think anybody's capable of anything, but do I think... I don't know him, but the type of person he's portrayed to be, I would say no.
I would say no because a few of like his cast members or mates, whatever, have come out, have reached out and said a few things. Like Stacey Dash said something. So did the little girl that played Olivia on the Cosby Show. What's her name?
Olivia. Raven Simone.
Yeah, she even came out and said, like, you know, that man never touched me, you know, did anything to me. So, I don't know.
Well, I mean, if he's doing it to women or was he wasn't doing it to kids, obviously women, so she was a kid back in
the
day. True. So, maybe he wasn't into kids and just women, but I don't know. I don't know. I don't think so.
Well, let's
see. Sorry, I don't believe you, Janice.
Yeah.
You're not a credible witness.
No, she's definitely not.
She's not a credible victim.
She's been high since 1922, as you would say.
Right.
Sorry, honey.
All right, so let's get on this. It may be a little bit older right now, but I still, you know, want to have a discussion about it. the Aaliyah movie, okay? I got a chance to see it a day later. And I don't, you know, on some real shit, I don't understand the big hoopla about the movie. Like, yeah, there were a couple of characters that should not have been casted as, like, as Missy? Such. Missy Elliott? For real?
It's supposed to be Missy now, because it looked like Missy now, not Missy later. Earlier.
That don't look like Missy nothing.
Well, I like R. Kelly. How do you
R. Kelly. I don't have an issue with R. My main issue was Missy. For real.
I didn't even get to see the movie because, for whatever reason, my thing didn't TiVo it. But, all the little memes they got going on.
Oh my God.
Hilarious.
Well, they said it was bootleg. They couldn't even play the music from Aaliyah because they weren't allowed.
What? No, they played a couple of her songs. So they played Let Me Know and one more that I think probably the family didn't have the rights to. Maybe somebody else had those rights. Because she sang those two songs and the beats weren't. It was a little twang in the beat.
Yeah. And they weren't her vocals. That's what's so sad is that you didn't hear any of her vocals.
They probably redid it. If you redo it.
Right.
And you're producing, like you're actually producing it, for, like a band plays a song and reproduces it, they don't have to have.
You're right. And that's probably what happened. But my thing with the vocals is it's not that necessary because think about Notorious, okay? The movie about Biggie. And the girl that plays Faith Evans, she did all the vocals. Faith didn't do anything.
Right.
She just happened to know how to sing and she looked and kind of sounded like Faith.
Yeah, she can sing for real.
Yeah, right.
For real, for real.
So, you know, I don't. And then people are getting like going hard on the chick that played Aaliyah. Like, I think she did a great job and she's a credible actress. Like she just did that VH1 movie that just came out, but Drumline 2. She did that.
Oh, she did.
She's playing Ice Cube's wife in the new NWA movie. So, you know, like she's an actress. They didn't just pull her from somewhere saying, so, you know, people coming down on her, I think that's wrong. She got paid to do a job and she did it.
She did the job. I think, you know, the little part that I did see, I think she did it well.
Right.
I don't think she did it terrible.
You know, I feel like the movie could have been. I do feel like it was a little shallow. They didn't get that deep into situations that I feel like they should, especially the R. Kelly situation. Uh-huh. Like, that should have been way deeper than what it was, but it wasn't. They didn't show the ending of her dying in the plane crash. I feel like they should have showed something, maybe her getting on the plane. Because even when we saw the La Bamba movie, he died on the plane. They showed it.
Right.
You know, so
that's
what?
That's true.
If that's the legacy and that's what happened,
they could have
then,
done like original footage or something like that from like her crash.
Right.
Like how they had it, you know, in the media. They could have done
that. Wendy Williams says she felt like it was tacky to show that about the death, but it's all online anyway, so how was that tacky?
I mean, this is
it's life.
About her life.
Yeah, right.
And that happened in her life. So why would you not show that?
I actually had my cousin died in a plane with her.
Oh, really?
She's a hairdresser, yeah.
Oh, are you serious?
Wow.
Yeah, oh. So.
That's sad.
Heart.
Yeah, so I don't know. I hope that the parents or that Aaliyah's family will someday decide to like do the movie the right way.
Yeah, I was
I think her fans deserve to see, you know, more into Aaliyah. She had a big fan base.
Why are they so against it?
Because I feel like there is something to hide. There is something to hide that they don't want the world to know about Aaliyah as far as her personal life goes. Because, you know,
You don't have to put everything about her personal life in there.
But she was only 22, so I think everything has to be there. She wasn't an old-ass lady.
Yeah.
You know,
I mean, that's true, but if they wanted to do something, they can do something where it, like, focuses, like, on her career. Like,
right.
What she's, you know, done in her career.
But she didn't do that much.
And like, highlights and stuff like that.
She didn't do that much, though. Think about it.
She did a couple movies.
She only did two movies. She was supposed to do the Matrix movies, but she died.
Right.
You know, like, she had her couple of albums, but she died at 22. So I feel it's something that they're hiding. I think it's all the R. Kelly shit.
Yeah, that's what I think. Too.
And they don't want people to know that. So, I don't know.
Come out someday.
Yeah. Someday. Okay, so lastly, I wanted to get into our clip of the week, okay? Somebody showed me this, and it's like, it's a hit all online on Instagram and Facebook. All right, let's check it out, and I want to hear what y'all think after we check it out. So go ahead.
Because I'm going to keep it G real. I don't fuck with you because you disrespecting me. You disrespect my hood by telling me take off my flag, asking how gangster I was, nigga. You lucky on that day I was acting cool, because I told you I ain't got time for that, but nigga today I got time, cuz.
G-Real. Today I got time, cuz.
Today I got time, cuz.
Oh, no.
On the G-Real, nigga.
He got time to get his ass kicked.
Oh, my.
Oh, no.
But nigga, you came up on me on some fun shit. Nigga, I don't make peace with niggas that come up on me on some disrespectful shit when I didn't even know you, nigga.
Okay, I saw this.
Yes, this has been, like, everybody's been posting this.
I saw it a couple days ago.
Yes.
I about died laughing.
I got time today,
cuz.
What do y'all think about that? First of all...
I think I would have stepped on that little boy.
You know what? I would have put my kid in the back seat, strapped him up in the damn car seat, and whooped that nigga's
ass. And gave him his time.
Yes.
You want time today? Oh, for sure. You can get your time.
Where are they at, though? He nigga in, like, nigga, like,
right.
You ain't black.
Nigga, you ain't YG, nigga.
Oh,
what?
My God.
I don't understand.
That...
I don't even have words for him
because
on the G real, but what?
Then
what?
You
what's
sound
that G real?
Dumb.
A real G. He dyslexia, dyslexic. Dyslexia.
On the G real,
he sounds so dumb.
And what the fuck is up with his belt? What like?
What's up with him?
He had on a seatbelt as a belt.
Nigga, what's that nigga Instagram? Anybody has this man's Instagram? Hit me at Nene Nice. I want to see him for real.
This nigga had a seatbelt on as a belt. Okay.
Hey, that was cool.
Holding his pants up. Oh my God, that's crazy. Yeah.
But I did see that video and the shit is hilarious. I watched it about 5-6 times.
You gotta catch that fade, like
that Michael Jackson.
Talking all that shit.
You have to.
I would have caught that fade.
But you know what I feel
day.
Like? I feel like he got into it with old boy. At that time or whatever.
Right.
The big homies made him go and do that shit. They made him say all that. So he had to act hard in front of them.
Yeah, I guess.
That's how I feel. That
on the G real.
They was going to DP him if he did
it. On the
and they
G-real.
Allowed him to say nigga for this video.
I got time today, cuh. That's ridiculous. Right, on the G real. On the G real, we're going to go ahead and get into the new joint of the week, okay? It's a cat named Genesis. He has a song called Coco. So let's go ahead and get that going. When we come back, we'll get into Dust Bags of the Week and the reality wrap up with Nene Nice here on the Get Down on RMCOnAir.com.
Shots, now he kneel. Matrix. I got baking soda. Baking soda, I got baking soda. Whip it through the glass, nigga. I'm blowing money fast, nigga. I'm in love with the coco. I'm in love with the coco. I got it for the lolo.
This is a word.
I'm in love with the coco.
I done been through a whole lot. Trial, tribulation, but I know God. Satan wanna put me in a bow tie.
Pray that the holy water don't go dry, yeah, yeah. As I look around me, so many motherfuckers wanna tell me. But enemy gon' never drown me. In front of a dirty double mirror, they found me. And I love myself.
The world is a ghetto, because
of
dick inside.
I love myself.
But it can do what it want when they want, I don't mind.
I love myself.
What you gonna do? Lift up your head and keep moving. Or let the paranoia haunt you. Peace to fashion police, I wear my heart on my sleeve, let the runway start. You know the man's about to love company. What do you want from me and my scars? Everybody lack confidence, everybody lack confidence. How many times my potential was anonymous? How many times the city making me promises? So I promise this.
I love myself.
The world is a ghetto because of dick
design. I love myself.
But they can do what they want whenever they want.
Police and a rock on the corner and a line full of fiend and a bottle full of lean and a model on the scene, yeah. These days of frustration, keep y'all on tuck in rotation. I duck these cold faces, post up, feed 5-4 for basis. Dreams are reality's peace. Blow steam in the face of the beast. The sky can fall down, the wind can cry now. The strong in me, I still smile.
I love myself.
The world is a ghetto because of dick
inside. I love myself.
But they can do what they want whenever they want.
I'm a rich nigga, got your nail on my waist. Run up on me playing, I'ma aim it at your face. And that go for anybody, anyway. Hey, I'm a rich blood, by the way. And I'm having swag, roll it old like a tape. Bitch scared, yeah, like I got these bitches on the bay. Don't wanna talk, nana say I need some space. Whoop, 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 my new car geeked up. I just paid the cop, now I'm running out of court. Panoramic top, I'ma put it on the rocks. Crawl, walk, and hop, got all of these bitches shot. Clone a young nigga and still flop. I buy banks by the two, no pop. Hey, baby, pay me the hook. Baby, pay me the hook. Baby, pay me the hook. Hey, baby, just play me the hook. Baby, pay me the hook. Hey, baby, pay me the hook. Hey, baby, pay me the hook. Pay me the hook.
Rubbing on my chain, blowing cloudmatic. Smoke something with a G and bend that ass backwards. Lay back, relax, and talk mathematics. Later on, we test a little sex practice. Write my name on the wall. Money in the mattress, bet she wanna get involved. She hop on the blunt, say with the hookah, y'all. I tell her pass back if the shit too strong. It's all set. Mozart are on the block, so wet. I got a wild wanna, and I ain't done yet. Looking at your future, baby, put down the cigarette. Come hop on this cush jet and take flight, yeah. Tell them bitches, fuck that. You wear the Latin bed, I got the magic carpet for that dash, yes. I'm also on one, got two Olsens on me. Big homie, young thugger, thugger, rolling Rolls Royce, so shawty.
Baby, pay me the hook. Ha.
Yeah.
Baby, pay me the hook. Baby, pay me the hook. Hey, baby, just play me the hook. Baby, pay me the hook. Hey, baby, pay me the hook. Hey, baby, pay me the hook. Pay me the hook, pay the hook, pay the hook.
Digits. Got me in the shower, she know that I leave it alone. So Felisa half an hour, she be trying to break in my phone. Feel insecure, but she gon' have to trust me, cause I ain't even doing no wrong. She won't ever get them 4 digits.
Get them 4 digits. She so damn nosy. Yeah. Don't know why she be listening to her friends. That's probably why she on me. Yeah. Cause they niggas be cheating on them. She just wanna be up in my photos. Yeah. She just wanna be up in my videos. Yeah. She just wanna be up in my emails and my DMs. But she won't ever get them 4 digits. No, she won't ever get them 4 digits. She
won't
ever get them 4 digits.
What's cracking, baby, other than my code? Just came off the motherfucking road. Already it's another episode. I think shorty undercover on the low. You know I be talking on the phone real late, Tom. She be walking in on me getting straight, Tom. I be like, okay, baby, stay calm. It's just Jake from State Farm. On the real, what you searching for? The thought upsets you, seeing it'll hurt you more. I'm out the game, but you know I gotta keep it player. Every night I say a prayer. She won't ever get the 4 digits.
No, she won't ever get the 4 digits. She about to lock my phone, tryna unlock my phone. She about to lock my phone, tryna unlock my phone. She won't ever get the 4 digits. She about to lock my phone, tryna unlock my phone. She won't ever get them 4 digits.
Hey,
we are back. To get down to rmconair.com. I'm Pretty Ricky.
And I'm Nene Nice.
And that was DJ Punch with the ones and twos over there. Thanks, sir. I will say that I do like that Eric Bellinger song, it's called 4 digits, right? But I don't agree with it.
I like Eric Bellinger everything, so.
Yeah, but I don't know. But do y'all go through phones?
Yes.
I don't go through phones.
Oh, I do.
Really? Yeah, I don't do that.
No.
If it's meant for you to know, you'll find out.
Right.
Trust me. Yeah.
It's good for me to know because I'm going to find the shit.
Right? The bitch will hit your ass. Trust me.
I am like phone hacker 101. Like, yeah, I don't know that.
Hey, Nene. That's right.
That's
right.
They got an app for that now, you know, right?
But then again.
They got an app. You go on somebody's phone, you go to try to get in. It takes a snap picture of you. It takes a snap picture of you.
That's what they get.
Being going through your phone. So you go through it, you go, and you go, how's that? You're going through it. It takes a picture of you going through the phone.
That's dope.
That's fine.
That's funny.
I'm going to go and delete the picture.
I want you to see
me. I will tell you.
You can't. You got to put a code in it.
Okay, so y'all already know that I have put the app on my ex-boyfriend's phone.
Yeah.
Oh. And yeah, I had all his shit. Nigga, don't play with me.
Yeah, I don't do all that.
Yeah.
All right, so it's time to get into this bag of the week this week. So I'll go ahead and start it off.
Okay,
so the desk bag of the week for me goes to this punk rock ass bitch at Lowe's, okay? Now.
Oh, God.
I just started, so it ain't me.
Yeah.
Ain't you another bitch, huh?
Right.
Nope.
This bitch was dressed, number one, like she was finna go to the club, okay?
Wait, working?
Yes. Okay, with her lumberjack motherfucking shirt on.
She had heels on?
She had on, like, these Santa Claus boots. She had on some Santa Claus boots, okay?
Okay.
Anyway, she's skinny as fuck. She thinks she popping, got her cell phone out. Bitch, I'm with somebody, we trying to find out, like, where certain stuff is. Because, you know, you walk in Lowe's, Home Depot, you don't know where the fuck anything
where
is.
Nope.
The bitch didn't even know where nothing was.
She just started.
She's talking to her homegirl about some club they finna go to tonight. Like, of course I'm tuned in because I'm listening. My ears,
right.
My radar be up.
And
I'm like, bitch, you talking about the club, but you can't even tell us where the fuck the damn drywall shit is. Like, are you serious? She like, it's over there. Where is over there?
It's between aisle 1 and 40.
Like, bitch.
So you find that.
Dust bag ass bitch, how about you get on your job, do something. Like Pinky said, do something. Yeah, she's a dustbag ass bitch. So, yeah, dustbags go to Lowe's for hiring dumbass people just because, and they don't even know
Rock,
where the fuck nothing's at.
We hope you don't act like that.
Wow.
I'm gonna need you to know where the shit is at. You work at a store.
I already know
where
stuff
is.
I don't even work there because I go there so much to build stuff.
Keep in mind, it was three people in the damn store that didn't even know where the shit was. Three different people. Are you serious?
Yeah, y'all should. Matter of fact,
Lowe's is a dust bag of the week, okay?
Yeah, because at the end of the day, they have so much stuff there. I feel like they should have like a little diagram on each, you know, what's on each aisle.
That's I think it's a girl thing because guys usually know where stuff is.
I'm sorry, I can't tell you where this nail is. Guys. I don't even know what the hell that nail. This is why I don't go to Lowe's or Home Depot. I hate that stuff.
That's the same way we feel. If we go to the Mac store. We don't know where nothing is.
Well, why would you go to the Mac store?
Well, we have to go buy stuff for y'all.
I don't know nothing in the Mac store.
I would never.
That's why you ask?
I would never want no man to go buy me no makeup from nowhere. No, sir. Give me the money.
Okay, so if I went to the Coach, whatever.
I don't even like Coach.
Give me the money.
I don't like Coach.
You're going to say everything I say.
No, but you can say something else.
Who wears Coach?
Yeah, who wears Coach these days?
Bye.
I don't know. Purse.
Bye.
Big ass bag. That's what y'all carry. Big ass bags.
No, actually, I have a nice small
bag. The bitch that work in Lowe's, she wear Coach.
Bags.
The bitch. That bitch
wears
Coach shoes. Coach
Dooney and Burke. Oh, bye.
Dooney and Burke.
What's the other one? Michelangelo. What is that?
Michael Kors?
Michael Kors. Don't get it twisted. Michael Kors still rocks.
No, Michael Kors.
I just know y'all carry that damn big ass purse through the club. Y'all need wheels on that motherfucker.
I'm sorry. I carry small purses.
Right, it'd be big ass bag.
No, airport bag to the club.
Big ass bag, man.
I've never done that.
No.
Get a Michael Kors purse or something.
I put everything in my bra. Like,
yeah, my ID be in my titty.
Or a clutch bra. Clutch purse or something, man.
A clutch bra.
Knocking people in the head trying to get the drink with the big ass bag.
That is so tacky.
You trying to dance a big ass bag, isn't that? Get the out of
you turning around, knocking bitches in the head with your bag. Right. Like, bitch.
Boom, bitch. Get out the
get
way.
Get that big ass fucking country bumpkin ass bag the fuck up out of here. Like, that's that ratchet shit. That's that Eastside Watch shit right there.
Oh, no.
Eastside Watch.
Eastside Watch bitches be checking them big ass, raggedy ass Dooney and Burke Coach purses in the fucking club.
DMV with the rainbow color.
They can get a dust bag for that one. Okay, so I have a dust bag too. My dust bag goes to all you men.
Uh-oh.
Actually, not all you men. A particular man. I really don't even know his name, to tell you the truth. But he hit on me, so I gave him my number. He told me to follow him on Instagram and that he was single. But his first picture of his girlfriend saying the only woman I need in my life. I was like, nigga, don't tell me to follow
you. That's happened
Instagram,
to me. That has happened to me. Niggas think you are dumb enough to still fuck. The sad thing about it is bitches be still fucking with niggas that got women and they know it. Niggas think they can get away with the shit. That's happened to me. Like, this nigga be hitting me up still. Remember I told you about old boy?
Yes, yes.
Still hit me up still, but yo, he changed his Instagram name to One Wife, Three Girls. Wow. All right, nigga. What the fuck?
Wow.
But you sending me dick flex in my DM. Nigga, I screenshot that shit, nigga. Yeah, so your bitch ever hit me up, nigga.
Oh,
I'm just gonna be
my
like, look,
one
here,
wife,
wants your
three
dick,
kids.
Bitch. Here. One wife, three kids.
That's his name?
Oh, no.
That is terrible.
Yeah,
that's
I put the shit out there. Yep, I sure did.
So
I could put your name out there, but we went to high school together, so I'm not.
All you niggas are dust bag bitches.
Amen.
Amen.
For doing some dumb shit like that.
Amen.
Like, if you're gonna do that, at least cover your shit up.
They don't care. Because bitches still fuck with them anyway.
I'm sorry. Well, I am not fucking with you. You have a girlfriend, and I know about it.
That's the weakest fuck.
There are so many other niggas I can go, you know,
fuck with.
Fuck on.
Deep throat.
Right.
Oh,
bye.
Any more of the dust bag? I agree with that.
Yeah, I agree with Nene. Along those lines, I have a dude that I was going to put in the dust bag because we met. We met, and he wanted to go out on a date. And so, you know, I live in Pasadena, and he's in Van Nuys. So I was like, oh, okay, so you want to come hang out in, Pasadena? And he's like, no, I was thinking we could meet up in NoHo. Why? Who hangs out in North Hollywood?
He does.
Yeah, that's 2009. Like, who, like, are you kidding me? I have to drive far to you. So I hit him back and said, listen, you know what? I'm coming all the way from Orange County. Do you think maybe we can meet up in, like, Burbank or Glendale? And he was like, well, to be honest with you, it's close enough to NoHo, so you might as well. No, it's not!
So, wait, are y'all meeting up somewhere?
No, I didn't answer him no more.
But what was the purpose of meeting up and we are going to go out on a date? Go to eat.
Yeah.
Why he can't come pick you up?
Right.
Why can't he just come to my side of town?
Wait. It's the first. But it's the first date. You don't let no dude pick you up on the
exactly.
first date.
Exactly. So he could have just came to Pasadena that nigga. And met me in Old Town.
Yeah, you don't know that nigga.
That's why Carrie and I thought stabbed that nigga.
Well, ain't nobody gonna see nobody now.
Yeah. Erica ain't playing that shit.
These niggas is spoiled these days. You know what I'm saying? They straight bitches. That's what it is.
I agree.
They want to be relevant so bad.
You know what it is a lot of, I think that a lot of women allow men to get away with certain things.
Yeah, not me.
You know, because back in the day, people were really like chivalrous and like open the door, open the car type
thing. I will stand at the door and you will think I'm crazy because you're going to come open this motherfucking door.
But I know that even like my homeboys, like my homeboys open doors for me. And I don't even fuck them.
I was a punch, be like, what's wrong with you? Your door stuck? It gets stuck sometimes. You got to hit it.
But I think we talked about this, though, as far as, like, the whole car thing. I'm not really big on you opening my car door.
I'm not tripping off that. But
if it's cold outside, I can probably open it faster than you can. So, yeah. I'm not trying.
Right. I got a dust bag.
Oh, what?
Yes, let's hear it. So we talking about people. I'm going to go. Reed ain't here, so I got to pick up Reed's.
Yeah, do it.
Gesture. So I did, last Saturday, I did this as a $1,000 plate. Event at in Temecula, City of Temecula, is on a ranch, right? Mm-hmm. But there's a line to get in, right? There's a guest line of people that
$1,000 a plate, nigga. Yeah. What the fuck was they serving?
I was trying to steal some plates, but I don't think it was
a whole live lamb, my nigga. No,
so we get there, and it's already cold out there, right?
Freezing.
My dust bag is women that go to clubs or go to events and dress skimpy, knowing it's cold. If you are not in the guest list or you're not on the guest list and you know you ain't got to stand in line, why the fuck you out there in the skimpy ass clothes complaining about it's cold? That's
because
shit for people that are going to walk
inside,
straight in. But that's shit for people that's going straight in.
Because when you get inside, it's going to be hot.
So you just stand out there and freeze your ass off.
Bye.
I'll be out there with a big ass coat.
Because you know me, I do not dress skimpy, number one. Number two, I'm not dressing skimpy when it's cold. Fuck all the bullshit.
Well, if I'm going to
cold,
a club.
Okay, if I go to a club, though, I'm not standing in line.
I wouldn't be caught dead with a peacoat on in the club. That's just not
happening. Oh, yeah, no. I'm not saying wear no peacoat, but at least wear something that's warmer.
I'm not wearing no scarf in the club. I'm just going to be
wear
cold.
Some leggings, or you can wear... I don't know, something
I'm
going
to just be cold then. Fuck it.
But it
fuck
was,
all that.
It was funny doing the event, because as soon as I got there, I had to set up. So the owner of the house met me at the gate, right? Uh-huh. All white people.
Oh,
I'm the only
house.
Black person there.
Oh, you said on a ranch.
It's
that's
a
right.
ranch,
okay.
Yeah. So another lady,
yeah,
you know, other black people, like
they
two, three black people
house
showed
house.
Up. Yeah, huge it's backyard, huge. Horses in the back. And
so the
ridiculous.
Event was outside.
It was outside.
Oh, then yeah,
so
you got to have
there.
A coat on.
In Temecula, it's
yeah,
cold.
Yeah. Yeah. So I gets there, and the owner of the house comes, little white lady. She goes, you're the DJ? I said, yeah. She said, you got any of that mustard on the beat, hoe?
Oh, my God, you
start busting up, yeah. So through the day, I'm playing like, you know, Liberace, some Frank Sinatra, you know, stuff they like and listen to. Around 9 o'clock, she comes back to us. She said, you got to turn this shit up. You got to get it turned up. This shit sucks. This shit's
yeah,
whack.
Yeah, white people love, they love hip hop.
She said, must
they love
home.
It.
And I got to, I started playing some other stuff. I got to the ratchet. It went off in there. I was like,
yeah,
wow.
They love that shit.
Wow.
Oh,
I thought I was
God,
at the
that's
GS.
That's hilarious.
The GS in Temecula. That's hilarious. Anyone
that GS ranch.
Punch, you got a dust bag? No? What? Your life is too great right now.
Right.
Need you have some dust bags. All right, let's get into the reality wrap-up with Midnight Nights.
All right, so let's start this off with our wonderful favorite show, quote-unquote.
Oh, goodness.
Love and Hip Hop. So this week, not much really happened, but I did want to highlight a couple points. Morgan and Ray J. You see, she kind of goes off on him. So once again, I'm thinking there's a little more to the situation than we know. Because she really is mad. Like, she's really, because I think a lot of this stuff is made for TV.
Yeah.
But she's really going on all her interviews, like, fuck that nigga, da-da-da, he ain't shit, he ain't got no money, this, this, and that. I'm like, you really mad about.
Well, he has money, because we know he's getting paid off that Kim Kardashian sex tape. So.
Yeah, we will be talking
still?
About that in a minute.
Still.
We'll be talking about
the
that in a minute.
Still watching that.
Pervs.
Oh, come on.
So, So what do you guys think really went on between Morgan and Ray J? Because I obviously we've said it. We think there's a little more.
They was fucking.
They had sex. Exactly.
Yep. They had sex. Exactly. And I think, but I don't think it was a relationship. I think it probably was like a few times, an accident. Yeah. You know. But we got to get back to the work. We can't continue to do this. Right. But the feelings are still there.
Yeah.
You know, I know all about that all too well.
In I agree. Situation,
so yeah.
No. Yeah. No. I totally agree. That's what I think as well. So. Next is Masika and Hazel. So we see that they kind of get into it a little bit. Masika is Berg's date.
Masika, that bitch.
She's that a dustbag bitch.
Is
she's
a dustbag ass bitch. She talked all that shit on all them episodes about her, about Hazel and Berg, and how Berg was this, that, and the third.
Right.
Then you end up fucking with the nigga. And then you end up fucking the nigga. And you know Berg is just want to fuck. Anything with a pussy. Like, I don't understand.
Yeah. And he's trying to make her seem like she's just like, he's going to like slow down for her and this and that.
No.
Bye.
She is just trying to come up. She's trying to get him to come up.
Oh,
any way she can.
Of course. So we see that like she, to me, I'm like, so she came out of the woodworks of being a singer. Because I thought she was a model.
All of a sudden, yeah.
Right, so.
Keep in mind, though, when she was singing in the studio, it had that good old T-Pain, what's that shit called?
Auto-tune.
Shit.
So I'm like, okay, Masika. So that was, to me, she could have got dust back if I didn't have another dust bag.
Yeah.
She could have got the dust back for that, because that shit was ridiculous.
She could be one next week.
Berg, you're always a dust bag every week.
Yes.
Nigga, and that's why your ass is off the show.
Dust bag of the decade.
You are anything broke with a pussy. Again.
I heard they took him off the credits too already.
Damn.
They should have. I look at that nigga. I saw her kiss him and I almost threw up in my mouth. Like, that's how
he's thirsty.
Yes, and his voice is so
And you don't gotta be thirsty. You are a producer. Like, you're already in the field. You don't gotta be thirsty. Why are you being thirsty?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's just disgusting. Yeah, bitches is fucking them, though. That's what's the nastiest thing about it.
Right. So, next thing I want to talk about, speaking of love and hip-hop, you already mentioned that Ray J is still making money off of the Kim Kardashian, you know, sex tape.
Yep.
So, reports, they're saying
don't
that
hate
me,
I'm hating.
I didn't watch it the first time it came around.
They said he makes still $90,000 every 3 months.
Ah, damn.
From the sex tape.
And especially now, because of her paper magazine, people are curious that aren't familiar with Kim Kardashian. You know, as generations get older, they don't really know. So now they are curious, and they're going to buy that damn sex tape. So supposedly he just made 50 G's in 1 week.
Oh,
from that paper magazine release.
That's insane.
He gets to show his. He winning.
He's definitely not broke.
He's
definitely
winning.
Not.
He gets to show how big his dick is.
His dick is big, though.
Yeah.
And
get paid off of that. Nigga, that's what's up.
It is. I mean.
Because Kim wasn't doing shit in that video. I don't give a fuck with nobody.
So I wonder how much he's making. How much does Kim make?
A lot, probably.
She got to
more.
Be making way more than that nigga.
And she laughing all the way to the bank.
All the way to the bank.
I don't hate on her
at
all.
And I'm laughing right there with her. Like, bitch, give me some money. Okay, so next, I want to talk about Real Housewives of Atlanta. So we know that Apollo went to jail. And
that dustbag ass
nigga.
Been in jail
for about, God, what has it been?
Since October,
like,
right?
Like 2 months or
yeah.
so? Something like that.
Yeah.
So they're saying that now, since he's been in jail, he's had time to kind of reflect and do this and that. And he now knows that he has lost his family, and that he's really sad about it, and that he's hoping now they can reconcile him and Phaedra.
So, bye, Apollo.
Bye, Apollo.
We don't want no Apollo G's. Over here, nigga. You knew what the fuck you was doing. You been cheating on Phaedra. I don't, something about Apollo that I just get my woman intuition on, he ain't a right nigga. Like, he just...
Well, obviously, I mean, at the end of the day, like, to me, Phaedra knew what she was getting into with that nigga. So, but him, if he was smart, he would have just worked for her and got paid. Like, you'd have to go and do all this fraudulent shit. Some your bitch has money. But and some, you're on a TV show.
Yeah, but some right. niggas don't want to do that because then she controls everything. And she controls the money.
But then like, she think you're on a TV show, though. Like,
they don't get as much as the wives do.
Well, of course they don't. But, I mean, use that shit to your advantage. Do something. Yeah. Like, you didn't have to go and do no fraudulent shit. Now you're in jail for 8 years. You know what I mean?
Whatever happened to them workout DVDs?
The donkey booty?
Sizzle to the back.
That was never released.
They must didn't do that great like they claim it did. Because
I never, ever saw. I don't think I would ever use Phaedra and Apollo's workout DVD.
I don't even use. Who fucking buys DVDs?
All people with DVD good players.
That's what Netflix and Hulu is for. Well, and my motherfucking cell phone and my iPad. Like, who buys DVDs? Like, no, that's not it. Go get a deal with Netflix and maybe do it on there. Because DVDs is a waste of fucking material in your car, in your house. Like, I'm for real.
Okay.
So.
It's like an old VHS.
It's true. Who still watches that?
I don't know.
So bye to Apollo. We will see you in about 8 years, sir. Sorry.
Or 4 years. No, he's going to do half of that.
No, that's federal time.
Really?
Yeah, you do all your time.
They asked him on the show and he said he was going to do like half of it.
No, you do federal. We have a federal case. Ooh, you do all the time.
I don't know. I don't care. I just don't want to be doing no time. So, yeah, goodbye, sir.
Right. So, last thing I want to talk about is Natalie Nunn is pregnant. I wanted to have congratulations to her. I'm surprised. Because I didn't really think she would have kids at this time. She's still trying to get her little shit popping.
Right.
But, yeah, you know, shit happens when you're married. So congratulations to her and her husband, Mr. Jacob Payne.
Well, you know, it's like a little controversy going on with that right now because the picture that they released with her husband and the dress that she's wearing, you know, it shows that she's pregnant.
Uh-huh.
And then if you go back on her Instagram page, a few of her recent pictures in that same dress from obviously the same day of the photo shoot, her stomach is flat. So either she's holding it in, but I know when I was pregnant, once that ball forms, it's hard to hold your stomach in. Like, right. it feels fucking weird. So, trust me, I tried it. So, it's like, and why would you want to hold it in?
Yeah, if you're pregnant, you're pregnant.
Yeah.
That's just what it is.
The fuck?
I mean, maybe at the time of the photo shoot when she did it, they didn't want to release.
Yeah, that picture right there, the one we're showing on rmcionair.com or at the Getting _ is that dress.
What I'm assuming is that at that time of the photo, when they were taking them, they didn't want to say anything until they got everything, you know, squared away.
Don't be out and about then.
Yeah, and I wouldn't be posting no pictures.
She got a gang of pictures in that same dress.
But that's social network now. You can wear what you're wearing right now and take a picture, and then a week later or a couple weeks later, you're wearing the same thing, and it just gets posted. You got a lot of pictures of the same thing. Back in the days, you wouldn't nobody notice anything because you ain't putting it up there like that.
But we're in today, and people do notice, and she is very popular.
Yes, she is.
I am nowhere near as popular as her, and I wouldn't wear the same thing that I've wore to the club in my photo shoot. I'm going to be fresh to death in a photo shoot with all brand new everything, and then I'll probably wear it again, mismatchy.
Mismatchy.
That dress turns into a shirt.
Switch it up, you know what I'm saying? So,
and last thing I want to mention is don't forget to watch Scandal tomorrow.
Ooh, yes.
And How to Get Away with Murder. It is the season finale of How to Get Away with Murder and winter finale of Scandal.
Don't you laugh at that, nigga.
So, anyways, that is it for your reality rap. We will be right back. Let's get into the mix of DJ Punch. This is the kitchen.
I don't fuck with you.
You little stupid ass bitch, I ain't fucking with you. You little dumb ass bitch, I ain't fucking with you. I got a million trillion things I'd rather fucking do than to be fucking with you.
little stupid ass. I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck. Bitch, I don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do. Don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do. I heard you got a new man, I see you taking the pic. Then you post it up, thinking that it's making me sick. I see you calling, I be making it quick. I'ma answer that shit like I don't fuck with you. Bitch, I got no feelings to go. I swear I had it up to here, I got no feelings to go. I mean, for real, fuck how you feel. Fuck your two cents if it ain't going towards the bill. Yeah, and every day I wake up celebrating shit. Why? Cause I just dodged a bullet from a crazy bitch. I stuck to my guns, that's what made me rich. That's what put me on, that's what got me here. That's what made me this. And everything that I do is my first name. These hoes chase bread, aw damn, she got a bird brain. Ain't nothing but trilling me, aw man, silly me. I just bought a crib, three stories, that bitch a trilogy. And you know I'm rolling weed and fucking up the ozone. I got a bitch that text me, she ain't got no clothes on. And then another one text me, yo ass next. And I'ma text your ass back like I don't fuck with you. You little stupid ass bitch, I ain't fucking with you. You little dumb ass bitch, I ain't fucking with you. I got a million trillion things I'd rather fucking do than to be fucking with you. Little stupid ass, I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck. Bitch, I don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do. Don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do. I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck, I don't give a fuck, bitch. I don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do. Don't give a fuck about you or anything that you do.
Got a million things on my mind, executive deals online, limited amount of time, chasing these dollar signs, and you ain't on your grind. You liable to find me up in the MGM casino in the deep. Fucking off Eddie, I could have put on property. From the beta to murder mitt, my niggas put murder mission. She choosing, that's her decision. Free my niggas in prison. On the phone with a bitch who can't do shit for a pimp, but make a nigga hella rich. Got a blunt and my dental, blowing hemp. In a rental, on my way to Sacramento, late night, Arsenio. I'm never sentimental, go hard or go homeless. Really hardly a chromeless, you might end up domeless. I bet you she into me, her cheddar she giving me. I make a bitch stand outside forever like the Statue of Liberty. Rest in Pimp C, underground king of the South. I raise my styrofoam up and put some drink in my mouth. Why you always coming around with bad news?
Bad news.
Say you want me to win, but hope I lose.
Hope I lose.
Ask never rock with other niggas in the crew. But them niggas cool. It's just that.
Bitch, I ain't fucking with you.
Bitch.
You little stupid ass bitch, I ain't fucking with you. You little dumb ass bitch, I ain't fucking with you.
Hey, what's up? This is Miss Erica with the Far Out News for today. So we all heard about this lady with 180 orgasms. So 180 orgasms, you have to wonder if she's wearing a diaper, because there's no way you can wear regular drawers with that type of stuff going on in your underwear. In your panties, okay? Next, I have some really bad news for JetBlue travelers. They are now going to start introducing fees, baggage fees, and reduced legroom, okay? And you have your fellow travelers to thank, because they are the people that got these in trouble, people getting kicked off of flights. One incident, this guy had a knee defender, which prevents the person from in front of him from reclining. So in retaliation, the lady threw a glass of water at him. Okay, so what do you do when two kids can't get along? You remove the amenities. So happy flight, happy JetBlue flying, and that concludes the Far Out News with Miss Erica. Shut up! Not yet!
I need a companion. Girl, I guess that must be you. Body like the summer, fucking like no other. Don't you tell them what we do. Don't tell them, you ain't need. Don't tell them, you ain't need. You ain't even gotta tell them, don't tell them, you ain't need. Don't tell them, you ain't need. You ain't even gotta tell them, don't tell them.
No, you say you're down with it. Don't tell them how you hit the ground with it. Girl, you know I'm from Chicago. I act a fool, Bobby Brown with it. In it, nobody take me out though. You got gifts, bring them down to South Pole. Marathon, girl, I put them out. Don't you worry about it, I gon' work it out.
Only if you got me feeling like this. Oh, why? I love it while grabbing the rhythm, your hips. That's right. Rhythm is a dancer.
listen, I need a companion. Girl, I guess that must be you. Body like the summer, fucking like no other. Don't you tell them what we do. Don't tell them, you ain't need. Don't tell them, don't tell them, you ain't need. Gotta tell them, don't tell them, don't tell them, you ain't need. Don't tell them, don't tell them, you ain't need. You ain't need. Gotta tell them, don't tell them, don't tell them, don't tell them, don't tell them.
DJ Punch.
The Get Down with Pretty Ricky and Nae Nae Nice.
Y'all chick come close to me. She ain't going home where she supposed to be. I'm getting money like I'm supposed to be. I'm getting money like I'm supposed to be. Oh, all my niggas close to me. And all them other niggas where they supposed to be. Oh, the hoes go for me. Now your chicks in the pit like post for me. Oh, that's how I'm supposed to be. Yeah, that's how I'm supposed to be. Yeah, that's how I'm supposed to be. Everything all like I'm supposed to be. Pull up to the club and it go up. Make your girl fall in love when I show up. It's not my fault, she wanna know me. She told me you was just a hummer. She came down like she knew me. Gave it up like a groupie. And that's facts, no printer. Cold nigga turn the summer to the winter. She saved me in her phone at bestie. But I had her screaming, oh. Yo, girl, wasn't supposed to text me. You wanna know how I know what I know? Yo, chick, come close to me. She ain't going home where she supposed to be. I'm getting money like I'm supposed to be. I'm getting money like I'm supposed to be. Oh, all my niggas close to me. And all them other niggas where they supposed to be. Oh, the hoes go for me. Now your chicks in the pit like post for me.
Let me tell you one thing about me. I'm a young nigga, fresh about the CPT. The only thing on my mind is getting rich. I go hard on a nigga and a bitch. Like, run me my money. Nigga, run me my money. Bitch, run me my money. Like, run me my money. Nigga, run me my money.
Call me a
bitch, run me my money. Nigga, run me my money. Before a nigga get murked, you would be another nigga on a shirt. Bitch, run me my money. You playing pussy, get fucked. Had a homegirls beat a bitch up. Money in my mind, money in my pocket. If you calling for a show, tell them run me my deposit. Half up front, the other half when I pull up. I'm leaving if you ain't got it. Tell my fans what up. Young nigga thugging, money over everything. I'm too real, yeah, the realest that you ever seen. So a nigga better have my money. A bitch better have my money. Straight up. Let me tell you one thing about me. I'm a young nigga, fresh about the CPT. The only thing on my mind is getting rich. Go hard on a nigga and a bitch. Like, run me my money. Nigga, run me my money. Bitch, run me my money. Like, run me my money. Nigga, run me my money. Bitch, run me my money. Like, run me my money.
Shorty fell in love with a hustle.
With a hustle, with a hustle.
Man, I took her from a bus.
From a bus.
Niggas keep talking like they know something. I slide on your bitch like she owes me. Don't panic, don't panic. We're just getting started, don't panic. Real niggas getting kind. Fake, fake is high. But don't panic, don't panic. We're just getting started, nigga, don't panic. But don't panic, don't panic. We're just getting started, nigga, don't panic.
Hey, nigga, where you from?
Westside.
Hey, get your gun.
Vanilla ice, vanilla ice. I take your shit like I'm Suge Knight. Spend a little money, get your mind right. I fucked your bitch, that's a highlight. You strapped up, you damn right. Try to ride me, cops picking up them shells. Like, I'm like, I was overseas all summer. Now my foreign car matches foreign numbers. Bitches wanna fuck me cause they nigga status. Bitches come and go, you ever seen magic? I seen a nigga on light, he was non-active. I was 50 niggas deep, I told him.
Don't panic, don't panic, don't panic. We just getting started, nigga, don't panic. Real niggas getting kind. Watch the fake niggas hide. Don't panic, don't panic. We just getting started, nigga, don't panic. Don't panic, don't panic. We just getting started, nigga, don't panic.
Girl, don't hide that pussy. You should be the type to provide that pussy. And let a thug hit it. You ain't gotta get dressed or do your hair, girl, like a 24 hours. Sex, sex and
fucking every day, nigga fucking every day. Say my life is like a movie, nigga fucking every day. Fucking every day, nigga fucking every day. Say my life is like a movie, nigga fucking every day. Missionary doggy style, nigga fucking every way. Go. I'm not the nigga you thought that trickin'. We off that, I hit that, no callback. She ratchet, I like it, I hold it. She bite it, she lick it and suck it. I fuck it, he wife it. No feelings for a hoe, that ain't my main thing. My niggas on the same thing. All my niggas gang bang, bitches ooh, too. This is my boo, two C's on the bag. But she throw up pop root, off the rock. She don't mind if I do. Her girlfriend a thought, tell her hop in my coupe. Tell her hop in my bed, tell her hop off my roof. My baby mama trippin' and that bitch can shoot. But you gon' let me hit it or not?
Can I get the dick or not?
You gon' let me watch you strip or not?
Can a bitch get a fit or not?
Girl, once you get it, you got it forever.
Com. I am Pretty Ricky.
And I am Nene Nice.
And that was DJ Punch on the ones DJ, and twos. That's right, baby.
DJ Punch.
All right, so it is time, officially time for the get down, okay? Yes. We have our guests in the building. I don't want to fuck up y'all names, so I'm going to try, okay? I'm going to try it. Brandon Vader.
Yeah.
And Michael Donatello.
Yes, ma'am.
Who is who? Which one is which?
Mike Donatello.
All right. Okay, so are these y'all original names?
Everybody says that.
Because Michael Donatello sounds like a Ninja Turtle to
me. Exactly. I hear Ninja Turtle all day.
You got the green background and shit.
Hey. No. These are all stage names, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so why don't you go ahead and plug yourselves. Let us know what you have going on.
We have
the single in front of us,
most
right?
Definitely, yeah. Right there, you got Bang That. That's the...
We're going to bang that later.
Yes, sir. No, that's me, my man. Brandon Vader right there. We actually got a show on the 24th coming up at the Observatory in the OC. We were opening up for Riff Raff that night.
Riff Raff.
You know, we just tore down the attic on Saturday in Hollywood.
Oh, okay.
Awesome. Yeah, we got They Ain't Ready. It's the album, the official album coming out in February. We got merch coming, you know. We not stopping this year, you know.
That's what's up. Yeah. Sound like us. Just people be on the radio side.
So, right.
So tell everybody where they can find you guys. Twitters, Instagram, website.
Yeah. You can find us on highclassmusicgroup.com. Our Twitter ad is highclassmusicg. And then on Instagram, we HICMG. Everything else is HICMG. So
okay.
Search that, you'll find us.
Awesome. Okay, so I hope you guys are ready for the show. So before we get started, I have to give you guys a, what am I trying to say?
Disclaimer?
A disclaimer. There we go.
It's initiation right here.
Yes. Okay, so before
you get into that, though, the reason we have to give a disclaimer is because our show is not like the typical show. We don't know if you guys have been versed before you got here about the show. But, you know, we like to do something different. We like to play games.
Okay.
We know a little bit about you guys', you know, lives, like, in a fun way. Yeah. Because you do interviews all the time. And people want to know, like, when your album coming out, you know, when your single.
Show.
Yeah. And it's like... It just get repetitive, you know, so we're going to have
fun.
And
we covered all that shit in like 5 minutes.
Exactly.
So, you know,
right.
Yeah, we're just good like that. So before we get started, let me give you a disclaimer. Our show is real, it's raw, it's nasty, and it goes there. We ask whatever we want, and nothing is off limits.
Okay.
So we're going to play a couple games with you guys. If you guys have to answer every question, if you don't answer the question, you will be called a Mitch, okay? Oh, and we'll blast you all on social media as the Mitches.
Yeah. Kevin Hart me, huh?
Yes.
Okay.
Nigga don't want to act like a Mitch.
So there is a die in front of you guys, I believe.
Oh, proper.
There it is.
Okay.
And go ahead and roll the die.
Somebody finally got it.
5.
Okay, so then what, Erica, you have card 5 over there?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Can I read it?
Yes.
Okay. Hip-hop trivia.
Okay.
Ooh, okay, I like that one.
In a while.
Okay.
Finally somebody picked one that I like.
Oh, shit.
You should like all the games, ma'am.
Okay.
I know, but, you know, I have ones. You know how people like one kid more than the other?
You know, bye.
Like one game more than the other.
Okay, so how this works, we're going to read you guys lyrics. You guys have to tell us the artist who said these lyrics.
Okay.
Okay?
Let's go.
You ready?
Yes.
Okay. We're going to talk big money. I talk big homes. I sell out arenas. I call that getting dope.
That's easy.
Samantha Hova.
Okay.
All right. You know, I don't like to do easy stuff, so. I run my prick the Yehudas. You couldn't measure my dick with 6 rulers.
Shit.
That's my shit right
here. YG.
No, it's a Big Pun.
Oh, shit.
Still not a player.
Oh, okay.
Okay, next one. If you hatin', you just need some pussy. She fucked up when she gave me some pussy.
Your boy Weezy.
Oh, you are a little too good at this game, so you might not have to be. You can't play this one.
She got me with a Big Pun, though.
I'm gonna get you again. Let's see. Remember when I used to play between your legs? You begged for me to stop because you know where it would head, straight to your mother's bed.
That's notorious.
Oh, okay. Yeah, all right. Got that one. You got me on that one.
Okay. I don't like playing with y'all because y'all be getting all shit.
Well, they're supposed to know this stuff.
That's what we
do. Yeah. The other people, I don't know.
That's because they be in there high as hell. They don't even know their own stuff. You said to them.
Right.
Absolutely. Okay. Shorty must have heard, got the word, I moved that D, had her by the bladder. She like, oh, I got to pee.
Y'all hit him with Jigga twice?
Damn!
Bye, sir.
You know that nigga's mine.
That must be like your favorite rapper. Yeah. I see you know all his shit.
Yeah. Right, right.
I can't give you nothing else from him.
Okay, here we go. Hip hop trivia. Left my nigga's house paid, picked up a girl, been trying to fuck since the 12th grade.
That's Q.
Damn.
Yeah, I know that one. He's like, I know that one. Okay, so next
my
one.
Time.
Don't let me tell you twice. I already told you once. Eat that pussy.
Oh, shit. Every rapper in the game.
Who hasn't said that? I don't know.
This YG?
No, this is a female rapper.
You're saying YG.
Because that nigga says
Lil Kim.
Shit.
I'm going to throw Lil Kim.
Nah, it's actually Nicki.
Damn.
Lil Kim's rival.
Oh, shit. Don't tell him.
All right, next hip hop trivia question. Slid the panties right to the side. Ain't got the time to take yours off site.
Yeah, y'all kill him with the Jay-Z lick.
God damn it!
you cannot give him no more Jay-Z.
And that wasn't
nothing.
Even a Jay-Z song. That was a feature.
Yeah.
That was okay.
That was Drunk in Love.
Yeah, that was Drunk in Love. Oh, he know what he talking about over there.
Okay, so next one. You don't know me, you just met me, you won't let me.
Shit. You know me, I gotta hear it.
Female? Male?
That's a male.
Male rapper?
Yes.
Can we get like a region, like the South, West Coast, East
West Coast?
Shit. Snoop.
No, it's actually Pac.
Damn. Oh, the nigga's gonna be mad.
All right, we'll do one more hip hop trivia question. And she don't like them pretty niggas, so ditty niggas. She ride this dick, her titties jiggle. That's my pillows.
Oh, wait.
That's Wayne.
Yeah, that's Wayne. Yeah.
Damn!
Yep.
Yeah, you mad for cups and shit?
All right, they definitely.
Okay, y'all got that one. Y'all were gonna
laugh.
I'm glad
that was not a drinking game because
we
would be fucked up.
Oh, shit.
I know. Okay, so roll the die one more time.
Got 3.
When a rich nigga won't check. Hey.
Party cut, turn it
off.
Ah! Swung too soon.
So, this is our official drinking game. So, hope you guys are ready.
Yeah, you don't got the answers over there, do you?
Of course.
We have to have the answers. Come on now.
But if you guys, so what happens, we're going to ask you guys questions. If you guys get the question right, we take a shot. If you get it wrong, you take a shot.
Okay.
Got it?
All right.
Okay, why am I thinking not pulling up? Give me a second. There it goes. Okay, so let me give you the first question. How long does the average male ejaculate? 4 seconds, 5 seconds, 6 seconds, or 7 seconds?
Shit, what the fuck is average?
Shit. You guys are a team, so.
You guys are a team, so if you gotta come up with the answers together.
We ain't teaming up on this one.
Seconds?
6?
Yeah, I'm guessing 6 too.
Oh, fuck, they're right.
No!
Oh, my God, please, Lord Jesus. You know I don't like alcohol.
Bang that shit.
Oh, my God, I hate alcohol. No. You guys don't even know.
Bang that shit. Oh, man, you shouldn't
be
have told
nice.
Us now. We got to...
Be nice.
I'm not.
Ooh.
Well, let me mix my with my Pitbull energy drink.
Oh. Make sure that they go down the hatch, vitamins. Though.
All right, you ready? Let's cheers.
Well, I gotta mix mine.
Oh, you're gonna mix yours.
Yeah.
Shout out to Pitbull. Ooh.
Hey.
Oh.
They took the whole thing.
Oh, hell no.
They did the whole thing.
Bye, Felicia.
Let me see yours, ma'am, because mine's not coming up for whatever reason.
My, like, throat is on fire.
You used to that, ma'am.
Yeah.
Get ready.
No. When I swallow, it doesn't taste like fire.
Ooh.
Hey.
Sorry. But it tastes like.
How did
I don't know. I don't taste it. I shoot it to the back of the throat, so it doesn't have to take on my tongue.
You got that throat. That throat.
Yeah, I got that
power. Mm-hmm. Got it. Okay.
Got that.
All right, party cup time up. Orgasms can lower a woman's risk of getting what? Heart disease, diabetes, ovarian cancer, or ovarian cysts?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, get ready to get them cups ready up over there.
Hey. Please, Lord Jesus.
I go with C. That's what they told me in school.
Ovarian cancer?
No,
the cyst?
The cyst.
Oh, yeah. So, is that your final answer?
Yeah.
And you guys are wrong. It's heart disease.
Turn up.
Go ahead and turn them cups all the way up.
Oh, shit.
Cups going up.
Hey.
On a Wednesday.
Oh, man. We're not going to do no chasers. This is for y'all.
Yeah. That's what's up. Okay, party cup turn up.
Okay, next question. In ancient Greece, women showed their vajayjays to ward off what? Evil spirits, storms at sea, syphilis, or the wrath of the gods?
I'm going to go with... I got B. I'm going to go with B.
With what?
With B.
Storms at sea.
And they're guessing.
I know.
Sure was. What was it? What was the answer?
Storms at sea.
Oh,
fuck,
shit.
My fucking throat. Damn.
Get it.
You know what, ma'am?
Huh? Couldn't be gods.
Mm-hmm. They're guessing.
Nah.
Yeah. Stop guessing right. Okay? That's a request I have. Yeah, I need to. Oh,
get your,
my God.
Get your B12 up. Get your B12. Vitamin
B12. All right, ready?
B12, B6.
B6. Hey.
Mm. Oh, hell no. That tastes like some old Robitussin.
Right.
Oh, yeah, it does.
Ooh.
That is so not good.
All right.
Keep coming.
Oh.
I keep guessing wrong.
Okay, did you get that one already? No?
No.
Okay. This STD may lead to heart disease or insanity. Gonorrhea, chlamydia, herpes, or syphilis?
Damn, heart
disease.
What
did Hitler have? Because that's crazy. Syphilis.
Fuck. Oh, I got it right. Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh my God. Did you? Okay, wait a minute. I have a question. Did you guys like listen to our previous shows or something?
We haven't played this game in a while though.
We're just not trying to take them shots.
Oh my God.
I have to drive far too. You guys are killing me right now.
That's what's up.
Well, y'all just making the person I'm going to very lucky.
Well, I'm going home to my bed.
Whoa.
Let me throw it back.
Oh.
Doing somebody else's job.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, Lord.
Mm. Oh, praise the Lord.
Woo!
Okay. For the sake of my throat and my chest, we're going to give you one more question.
Right.
So, let me make this good. Hold on.
I'll see.
Yeah, ma'am. Mm-hmm.
Going into the stompers.
Okay. I can't fuck with y'all.
Hey. I feel like she about to...
Okay.
She digging deep in the crates.
Right. She coming out the woodwork with it.
It is illegal to purchase or sell sex toys in what state?
That's a good one.
Utah, Ohio, Colorado, or Alabama?
That's not a good one.
It's not Alabama. She said Utah. It would make sense. The most sense. Utah. What's the other one?
If y'all know where the Bible Belt is.
Utah, Ohio, Colorado, or Alabama?
Alabama. Alabama.
Fuck, ma'am. It's your fault they got that one right.
Why? Because
yeah. You said the Bible belt.
Yep. Yeah.
A lot of people don't remember about the Bible belt.
Yep.
Oh, and they look young. I didn't think they would know.
Go ahead and drink that up.
Okay, so on that note, we will be right back with our guests. I'm going to recover from these shots.
They might not be back.
We're going to get into the mix of DJ Punch. This is the Get Down.
On credentials, we credible individuals ahead of you. We original, better known as criminals, thugging off on the stereo, killing them on the radio. Some of them want to hate me, though. Fuck, cause they can't see me though. And here we go again. The jealousy took you over success, just keep you slower. Wow, you get nothing, we keep getting more. Pump, pump the jammer, drop, drop the top. Hit, hit the switch, and smash down the block. And oh, yeah, it's Long Beach, so you know when you see a nigga. And don't ever get the wrong idea, nigga.
Yeah, nigga, what?
Holla.
Smoke, won't it? DJ Punch.
To Get Down with Pretty Ricky and Nae Nae Nice.
You will be mine.
You will.
Even if it's somebody else's. Girl, not for long.
Right.
Girl, not for long. Cause I'm your type.
You know.
If you got the wrong impression.
Yeah.
Girl, not for long. Girl, not for long.
Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow. Maybe at the club, maybe at the bar. I wanna show you off like a trophy car. Cause anything is better than nothing at all. Nothing at all. Nothing on you. I just wanna show you a table for two. All you did was go on a date with a dude. You know he don't fit, he ain't tailored for you. You be on a nigga dick cause he sold a brick. Has he ever wrote a hit on some poor shit? That's who you chillin' on the sofa with. I ain't trippin' in a minute, it'll be over with.
You will be mine. Even if it's somebody else's, girl, not for long. Girl, not for long. Cause I'm your type, girl. You got the wrong impression. Girl, not for long. Girl, not for long.
Together, hell no, they can't stand it. I wonder if you're matching your bras with them panties. A gorgeous skin set, hit them all and do damage. The way she hit the high note, we all gon' have Grammys. It's marble, not granite. From the counter to the shower for an hour. Superpowers. That's that mojo.
Yeah, baby.
Austin Powers, search real nigga. I'ma pop up in your browser. Ayy, so go on, get your body wet. Panties off, we ain't made it to the lobby yet. Put you on gang, girl, so it's obvious. I'll give you the word if you ain't got it yet. Bobby.
Superpowers, rap 225,000 hours. Get a calculator, do the math. I made 1,000 songs that made you move your ass. And for the last 300 months, I made 16 albums with me on the front. And they bump. Where you get your beats? I heard 93 rappers say bitch like me. 2 singers and 10 comedians. And I'm still gon' yell it every time you see me in. What's my favorite word?
Bitch.
Why they gotta say it like short?
Bitch.
You know they can't play on my court. Can't hang with the stay on the porch, blow the whistle. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle. Where you get that from? Grab a mic, spit one. Let me hit that blunt. Pimp C, 8-Ball, and MJG. Keep spitting that B to the IMP. Bun B, that's Texas, baby. Ballin' G, that's Memphis, baby. Short dog, that's Oakland, baby. Ain't nothing but pimpin' these days, G. My nigga C got locked up, but these real hoes still know they got to fuck. Give a fuck, nigga, what you say. Short dog, fuck with UGK. Do you really wanna be like me? Spit game like Snoop and T.I.P. Pretty girls in the VIP, they came with Dre. They don't need ID. Blow the whistle. Blow the whistle.
Yo, yo, this your man Mike Donatello.
Brandon Vader.
You're here right now on the Get Down Radio. What you're about to hear right now is called Bang That, coming up on that new They Ain't Ready, coming out in February. Let's get it.
Turn it up, bang that shit. And I ain't gonna lie, man, I'm way past lit. Cut to the rim, call that shit Blake Griff. We drinking all night, DJ bang that shit.
Yeah.
Bang that, bang that, bang that shit.
DJ
bang that,
Punch.
Bang that, bang that shit.
Turn it up.
Bang that, bang that, bang that shit. We drinking all night, DJ bang that shit. Cup to the ring, you know I'm fucked up. All these haters getting mad, nigga, so what? I'm too drunk, a little faded. Girls at my table getting X-rated. I don't know about you, but I've been on it. Y'all niggas offline, man, I've been on it. Rolling the blunt, hoes on my neck, man, you know what they want. They want a real nigga with a big dick. Come on, baby, watch your mouth, you know I'm ignorant. When they play this in the club, they gon' feel this. Tell the DJ run the track, Russell Wilson.
Purse up, bad women, yeah, I'm toastin'. Bottoms up, real niggas keep on pulling. Yeah, we in the same building, but I'm roped in. So keep your ass behind the ropes, you ain't dope, man. Turn it up, bang that shit. And I ain't gon' lie, man, I'm way past lit. Cut to the rim, call that shit Blake Griff. We drinking all night, DJ bang that shit.
Yeah.
Bang that, bang that, bang that shit. Bang that, bang that, bang that shit.
Turn it up.
Bang that, bang that, bang that shit. We drinking all night, DJ bang that shit.
Turn it up, what the fuck you turn it down for?
Whoa.
Say I got a big head, it's for the crown, no. Pull it up, about to drown, bro. All these girls turning up, bet they still down, though.
No.
In the club, still lighting up the reefer.
Whoa.
Smoke hit you in the face, call it Shark Keisha. Sorry, baby girl, see the must be the liquor, cause the bottles make it come, dick make it come quicker, hot.
No.
Cup overflowing, fuck, keep pouring.
What?
Throw it at me, girl, I'ma catch it like I'm Owen. One more shot, got you in your zoning. Making memories that are gone by the morning.
Clap,
standing ovation.
What?
1, 2, 3, 4 shots, yeah, we drinking.
Yep.
We about to party the high CMG way. So when you walk up in the club, tell your DJ.
Turn it up, bang that shit. And I ain't gon' lie, man, I'm way past lit.
Nah.
Cut to the rim, call that shit Blake Griff. We drinking all night, DJ bang that shit.
Yep.
Bang that, bang that, bang that shit. Bang that, bang that, bang that shit.
Turn it up.
Bang that, bang that, bang that shit. We drinking all night, DJ bang that shit.
My shorty always tripping, she don't wanna let me do me. I'ma hit this club, live it up. Baby, say bye bye.
I just tell my bitch bye.
We are back. To get down on RMCOnAir.com. I'm Pretty Ricky.
And I'm Nene Nice.
And that was DJ Punch from the ones and twos. And we just heard Bang That. And I like that.
Hey.
And we gonna really bang that shit though.
Right.
I was banging that shit.
Whenever I hear claps in a song, I just wanna make my booty do this.
You wasn't doing it though.
I was doing it in my chair.
Oh, okay. All right.
Don't get it twisted because I will get up and clap something in this studio. I've done it many times.
Can we run that back, DJ? I mean,
well, my tights is a little bit too tight.
It may not move.
It's not going to move. Yeah. All right. So let's go ahead and get back to the show. So far, you guys are down with the get down. So
yes. And you guys kicked my ass with these damn shots.
Yeah. She had to go. You know, she a grandma. She had to go throw up right quick.
Wrong. That's a negative.
All right. So we want to ask you a few questions before we get back into a couple of games.
Okay.
So, you know, I want to personally know about groupies. Like, I want to know one of y'all best groupie experiences. Because you're in the game, you know what I'm saying? You know? Because we got groupies and we in radio. So we know y'all got groupies.
All right.
Don't hold back. First of all, wait. Anyone of y'all got girlfriends?
Right.
Both.
Y'all both got girlfriends?
Yeah.
Are they listening?
I hope so.
Well, we hope so too.
We apologize to you, girlfriends, but we need
still want
to
know.
Hey, everybody knows how a groupie acts. So.
It is what it is.
That's a role.
Yeah.
Well, no, we don't know how a groupies act because we hear different stories in different scenarios.
Right.
Oh shit.
Everybody has a different story.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we not, you know, Justin Bieber and shit, but you know, and what kills it. Is when, you know, you want to post something on your Instagram, you know, with you and your boys or something, and and some female who, you know, could have been there that night, that you do know, but yeah, usually it's the ones that you don't know, and then they comment as if they do know you on the Instagram, so your girl's like, who the hell is that? And you really like,
they're like, oh babe, you so crazy.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Oh, shit, that shit was crazy, you know? So, that's happened more than once, so, you know, that's not just one time, but.
You got in trouble?
A couple times, yeah.
Who the fuck is that bitch?
Yeah, you know, just, you know, oh, I didn't tell you about that performance last night? Like, damn, my bad, yeah, I meant to tell you, you know, whatever, but nah, nothing serious. Nothing.
So, y'all haven't had, like groupies that, like, kind of, after the show, they want to, like, follow y'all and like be with y'all.
Yeah, I mean, that comes with the territory, but I mean, give them that Heisman, really.
Oh, wow.
You throw them a little curveball.
I mean,
huh?
Really. That shit don't get you nowhere. That shit's just trouble.
What do you guys feel about? I know you guys have girlfriends, but I guess before you had a girlfriend, what do you guys feel about fat girls? Do you guys ever fuck a fat girl?
Oh, I'm a chubby chaser.
A wall.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
A chubby chaser.
Yeah, man. Because you know, I'm
I never want one of those in the flesh. But the only one I know.
Right. No, I'm a skinny person. So you know, these
that's usually how it goes.
Yeah. You know, I mean, I don't.
Okay.
Go
so
for
what?
That
what
like,
about a fat girl?
Yeah. What about it? On
okay.
Him?
And then like what? Kind of fat are we talking about?
Yeah, see, you said fat. I said chubby.
Okay. Chubby? What kind of chubby are we talking about?
Shit. Who?
Like, not like Precious.
Hell no.
Okay.
Like Queen Latifah?
That's like unhealthy.
Or like a Jill Scott?
Jill Scott.
Nah, smaller than Jill Scott. Let's see, like.
Okay, but you seen Jill Scott now, though?
Yeah.
She's small.
Oh, she's small?
Oh, yeah, no, she's small.
Let me pull her picture up for you.
Yeah, she looks bad.
Yeah. Let me see that. You had to come back to
but
me.
But in the meantime, yeah.
In the meantime, how you feeling about fat chicks?
What's up? Oh, I thought it was this one right here.
That ain't me.
Hey, y'all like fat girls?
I mean, I guess if you word it like. See, when you worry
okay,
like
let
that,
me say,
sounds
let,
so
let me
bad.
Let me rephrase this for you since you're getting sensitive on me. You don't like chubby girls? Thicker girls?
No, I don't like them at all.
So you like toothpick girls?
No, not at all.
So you like
so
no
what
ass,
in
no
the
titties?
Fuck do you like?
Oh, all right.
Balance.
So, like, if she's 5'5", she got to be, like, 135, like, 140?
I don't know.
You just like what you like, huh?
Yeah.
You like your girlfriend. That's
you
cute.
Being
yeah,
difficult.
She perfect.
Okay, so what size is she?
He don't know. So she must have just the right
good
amount
size.
Of ass, just the right amount of titty.
Fun size.
All right, so with that being said, are you guys ass men or titties men?
Ass.
Why?
I'm more thighs though, but like
ass. Thighs. Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Thighs.
So like,
but thighs and ass kind of correlate together
right,
a little bit.
Right.
Although some
not
girls,
these days.
Some girls with thighs ain't got ass. That looks funny sometimes.
That looks pretty bad. That's illegal.
That's
a foul.
Okay, so your thigh
yeah.
slash ass.
Oh,
too.
Why do? Oh, yeah.
Your ass man.
Ass.
Okay, so it's okay for a girl to have a whole bunch of ass and no titty at all.
Yeah.
That's cool.
That's like boyish.
That's cool.
Like flat, like you guys. Like,
boyish. That's like
literally.
I mean,
like
y'all know
nipple.
It's like trannies out here that look very beautiful. They got
yes.
big ass,
have
fake booties, and no titties.
King Amaya, she looks like I don't know. Looks
oh,
like
shit.
She's bad as fuck. Bad.
She's a he. It's a
yeah.
She.
So this is Jill Scott now.
Yeah. See, that's cool.
That's too big for you.
Yeah, no, that's cool.
That's Jill Scott.
Man, get the fuck out of here. I'd fuck this.
All right. And
she's
I don't even like
right
women
here.
Like that.
That's what's up.
Okay, so she's too, that's too.
It's a little bit too.
That's just Jill Scott.
Yeah, though. That's just Jill Scott. Yeah.
Okay, what if it was a woman
okay,
shape
okay,
like that?
Okay, I'm sorry. Jill Scott right there is small. Okay.
Right. No.
Compared
no,
to what she used to be.
Right.
That's small. Because if you're saying chubby and that's bigger than your chubby, then you don't know what chubby is. That's not
hey,
chubby.
Maybe I don't like chubby girls. Then,
maybe you
know?
Don't.
Yeah. Maybe I like life
maybe
size.
It's chubby compared to your size.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. I'm trying to say, see,
but you're small,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, I'm a small dude, you know what I'm saying? So,
what are you, like, 105 soaking wet?
Damn, baby, that's what's up.
Damn.
Okay. Nah, I'm, you know what I'm saying? I'm average.
I was just fucking
I'm
with you.
Average weight.
All right,
you're
so how do you keep a girlfriend being in the business that you're in and, you know, you wanting to become more successful in it? Like, how do you keep a girlfriend? Because we hear stories all the time.
Right. Well, my chick's in the entertainment business. She's a reporter for Fox. So,
oh, awesome.
Yeah,
what's so her name?
It's easy. It's not out here. She in Georgia.
What's her name?
We ain't getting down to that.
Well, I mean, I'm just saying because Nene Nice has a secret herself.
Oh,
no,
shit.
I do not. I don't have no secret.
With Miles from Oisha.
No,
oh, shit.
I did hey, not no. fuck that man. I'm sorry. I like my man bigger. I don't like skinny guys. Sorry. No.
Shit.
Yeah. So, anyways.
Gotta fight.
You just shot him all the way down.
They both have girlfriends. What are they?
Oh, yeah, that's what? Right.
I ain't shoot nobody down. Y'all both have girlfriends.
Awesome. Oh, yeah.
Bet not the way y'all was talking earlier about that shit.
Okay, so, you guys, so your girlfriend's in the industry. Yours is not.
Nah.
No. Do you think it's harder because she's not?
I mean, yeah, of course. It's not the same situation. She doesn't
understand sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay, so I have a very interesting question for you guys. Since you are in relationships, when it comes to cheating, what is a deal breaker? Is cheating a deal breaker?
Yeah. Cause if she
okay, and
it,
what is cheating to you? Because it's different for everybody.
Yeah.
I say it's one more than you.
Right. Right. I believe that.
It's what?
Am I too faded to understand that?
I didn't get it.
So
either.
Like,
one more time, run that back.
So
if you cheat,
yeah,
then she could cheat one time, but if she cheat two times.
Oh, so if you cheat, then she can cheat. So she has a pass.
She has to. You'd be a hypocrite if you.
Yeah. Really now?
Huh. Okay.
I fucks with that.
Right.
But what if the dick that she cheated on you with the pass is bomb as fuck?
Then you ain't
that's
shit.
That's the price you pay.
Yeah, then you ain't shit. Get
interesting.
Your
okay.
I mean, you can't be like, I'm going to do what I want. You can't do nothing.
Yeah.
So cheating is a deal breaker for both of you guys.
Yeah. Just don't find out.
Yeah.
Just don't find out.
But why is it a deal breaker if you really love her?
I mean, because...
Everybody cheats.
I mean, everybody does cheat.
So then it just depends.
Or has cheated.
Yeah.
It just depends then, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, what's love really got to do with it like that? Because, I mean, at the
end... All right, Tina.
What's considered cheating, though?
Yeah.
Well, that depends on the person.
Yeah, see, that's too many stipulations.
Yeah.
Okay, but what is cheating, though? Like, yeah. A kiss, is that you guys?
Yeah,
it,
now,
like...
for me, it's anything physical. For me.
So okay. She can be texting a guy, and that's not a big deal.
If I seen it, yeah. I mean, yeah, you seen some text messages. I mean, it is what it is. Shit's...
But she's calling him, like, babe.
If you calling them babe, then clearly you not doing something. You not talking to your chick, so that's your fault. Clearly.
Y'all are some young, intelligent.
Okay, so what are you guys' ages? Because you said they're young.
25.
Okay.
That's what's up. Because I know some 30-year-olds that'll be like, nah, fuck that.
Interesting. I mean,
okay.
You got to live. We all going to die someday, so live it
okay,
up.
Okay, so you didn't say yours.
I don't know, man.
A kiss? That's cheating?
He like, yeah.
It just depends, man. It just depends on the situation.
It depends on the situation.
Different situation. It just depends.
Sometimes. He don't even want to think about his girl cheating at all.
Right.
It's bothering him that we've even asked him about the shit. Okay.
I mean, it is what it is. You can't control other people, so.
No, you cannot.
No, you cannot.
Once you accept that, it's hard for you to have an opinion on it. I mean, it's out of your hands. What you gonna do? Kill him?
No.
But you can do some things to make them understand that they don't cheat on you.
You got me fucked up.
Weren't we just talking about all the groupies that come along with the situation?
Mm-mm.
What y'all feel about threesomes? Have y'all done threesomes? Oh my God, I forgot you guys have girlfriends. You're not gonna answer the motherfucking question, honestly.
Okay, then they can answer because if you ain't done a threesome, it ain't gotta be with your girlfriend. It could have been before her.
Right.
But then if it wasn't with your girlfriend, then it's who the fuck is that bitch?
Right. They can't admit shit on here. Let's get back into some gangs, okay?
Okay, roll the die.
Y'all trying to get
We looking up for y'all.
We trying to get y'all in
trouble. Right.
Too late.
They got like 5 text messages each on their phone.
Right.
My phone has vibrated a couple times. So.
Back to back.
What would you do? Oh, shit.
What would you do?
That's okay. My game right here.
Yeah, I like this game too. This one's actually really fun.
Okay. What would you do? All right. So what would you do is a game. We're going to ask you a question, and it's lifelike. And we want you guys to give us your real response, okay? Like, because these are questions that can possibly happen in real life.
Right.
Okay, so don't give us no old shoo-shoo-shee-shee shit. We want to know the real response.
Okay.
Okay? You ready, ma'am?
Yep.
All right. Go ahead.
What would you do if you went out to the club and you met you a nice little thotty? And you took her back to your house. Well, you went back to her place for the night. When you wake up, her boyfriend is standing over you.
Oh, shit. So he just standing there?
Yeah, he's standing and looking at you. Mm-hmm.
And you naked up under there because she was fucking her. I mean, you know.
I promise on everything I love, I'll hit that nigga.
I was about to say that.
You hit him with what?
I hit it with that nigga with, nah.
Hit it with that left, right.
Yeah. What's good, nigga? Yeah.
Tony.
Yeah. Shit. Hit him with the left, hit him with the right.
Fake a seizure.
Right. I hit that nigga with, what's good? Shit.
Okay, so what if he was standing over with you and he had a weapon?
And he had a weapon?
Not like a gun, like a bat.
He had a bat.
A fork. I don't know. A knife.
A plate.
A fork.
My nigga had a big ass duffel bag.
I'm throwing his chick at him.
I don't want it.
All right, so what would you do if you had $20,000 cash in your wallet and it fumbled out your hand and into a toilet with another person's feces in it?
Oh, that's easy. Grab it.
Grab that shit. Yeah.
What?
$20,000?
Yeah. Feces?
These niggas 20, surviving
000?
Over Ebola.
Shit. Right. We going to the ECU right after that. We going to pay for that little sterilization and we out of there.
You smell your hands afterwards?
Hey.
No.
No.
We out.
Wash your hands. That's
20K. Shit. I mean, that's a show.
Okay. Next one. What would you do if you walked in on your girlfriend giving your dad head?
Oh, shit. Hey. Real life situations.
That could happen. Yes. Pops might have some game.
Keep it in the family.
Is he still married?
Keep it in the family.
Is he still married to moms?
No.
No.
Hell no. I'm going after his chick then after that.
Yeah.
He don't got a chick.
Right.
So
wait, are you mad at your girlfriend?
You walk in the room and bam, that's what you see. What do you mean?
That's done as far as that shit's concerned. That's
you say something?
Yeah.
That's not what it sounds like.
That's done as as soon as eye contact is made, that's all deals off. Yeah, now we're going after his chick after that.
Okay, so what if he is still married to your mom?
Well, that's fucked up.
Yeah, then I'm snitching.
All right, what would you do if you got invited to your boo's house for the first time? And once you got there, you sit on the couch and you happen to feel a roach crawling up your leg.
Oh, I'd scream.
It's just one roach?
What do you mean?
No, it's a whole family. Yeah, one roach.
That's all you need.
We good. It could just be some pizza or some shit up under the couch.
Oh, no.
Pizza no. Under the couch?
Bye.
Standing up in the corner the rest of the night. Just
if y'all let one little roach scare you away.
It's bold enough to crawl on you, my nigga. Like,
no.
What?
I don't do roaches at all.
I don't do ants, my nigga.
I'm like, bitch.
No.
I see one ant and I think there's 1,000. Like, I just feel them everywhere.
So y'all not tripping. It's one roach.
So
tell the girl, like, you know, it was a roach crawling on me?
Oh, hell yeah. No. Nah, we killed that motherfucker and I'm pointing it out. Like, that motherfucker's on my leg.
you gotta tell her about it, right?
You gotta clean that shit up, bitch.
Oh, no.
Take it to a clip.
Okay, so what would you do if your girlfriend's perverted aunt offered you $50,000 cash to let them give you oral sex?
Ooh, and y'all got girlfriends
and
too?
It's their cash and it's in front of you. So she have to let her suck your dick. And she'll give you $50,000.
Oh, it ain't easy. Now, 50 G, 20 G's? 50 G's?
Chanel bag's like 10 G's, right? So.
It depends on what Chanel bag you're talking about. Not all of them, no.
So, you wouldn't be happy with a $10,000 Chanel bag.
Are you letting the auntie suck your dick or not?
Hey, I'm just saying, we could peel off 10, you know? We could put 20 towards a little vacation. I could put 20.
So, he's letting the auntie suck his dick.
So, he's letting
the
auntie suck you off. Nigga, I might tell you to let my auntie suck you off. So
see, we all benefit. That's for
us. Yeah, I get half.
It's for us.
It's for us. Bye.
All right, what would you do if your girl asked you for a threesome? And you decide to go along with it, as you guys normally probably would. And then when the person comes in the room, it's a man.
Hell no. Nah. Hell
no. I mean, but he's not gonna touch you.
That's not a threesome. That is a train, and that shit is not happening.
That's a threesome. That's three people.
Nah.
That's
Thomas.
Nah.
That is three.
That's Thomas. That's two trains and one tunnel. That's crowded. That's what that
I
is.
Count that's
one,
crowded.
Two, three.
That's threesome.
Oh,
okay.
No.
So what do you say to her?
No.
Get the fuck that nigga out the crib. Hell
no. Okay, would you break up with her?
To be honest, I would ask her if it was a joke. I would ask her if she was trying to be funny.
No, he came in with his boxers on, ready to go. Like, you get the front, he get the back.
The KY ready.
Right.
I'm trying to give her the benefit of the doubt before I kill her. That's really what I'm trying to
do. All right, so no threesomes with a man for you.
Oh, no.
Got it.
What if it was like your friend?
Your with homie.
Your girlfriend?
Oh, man. I'm like, what the fuck you talking to this nigga for? This nigga in his boxers. Hold on.
Okay, shit. What would you do if you walked in on your mom and dad watching a porno together?
I would be fucking rolling.
what would you do?
I just laugh. That shit's funny.
I would probably, hey, y'all want me to be real? I'll probably Snapchat it. I'll be
you would snap. I don't. I don't fuck with Snapchat.
I would Snapchat
for those reasons, right there. Oh, Roxa, what's Snapchat?
All right, what would you
some
do?
Shit you don't need.
What would you do if one of your homeboys called you, your really close homeboys called you bae or hubby unexpectedly in front of a group of your folks?
Young thugger, thugger.
Hit me with the thugga thugga roll time.
Yeah.
I would just start rolling. Because I would think that nigga's playing.
Yeah.
I would just start rolling.
No, but he's serious.
What if he's like dead serious? Like,
he's like, oh, this is my love right here.
And he's like, you do one of these. You know?
Okay, now that's.
She put extras on it. Okay. I'm just saying, what if he's like, oh, yeah, this is my love right here. My love, Michael Donatello, right?
And Darth Vader over
that's
there.
That's when you get the LeBron. That's when you get the LeBron out.
Yeah. You get that open chest.
You bring out the chalk for that.
All right. Ooh, so y'all just laugh it off, like it's
nah.
Nothing.
That nigga's getting like a couple in his chest.
Okay. All right.
Okay. What would you guys do if your girlfriend's mom was mad at you and she purposely rammed her car into yours?
Call my insurance.
Yeah.
Call my insurance.
Yep.
Are you filing a claim against her, or are you going to say it's like a hit and run?
Nah, I'm fine. Oh, wait. Oh, she didn't stick a... Hell yeah, hit and run like a motherfucker, and I know where they live, too.
Oh, she did?
Yeah, yeah.
No, I'm saying, like, you see her do it.
Yeah, no, hit and run
and
like a motherfucker.
Like,
I got
you, nigga,
I got the address.
She just said, fuck you.
I got the address. I got the daughter's name.
Yeah,
I got
the EZL, my neck, my back.
Right, yeah. Yeah, I'm real hurt.
And you weren't even in the car.
Yeah, no, I'm hurt. The emotional damage.
Emotional damage.
What would you do if you caught your mom twerking it for a real nigga backstage at one of your concerts?
See, man, that shit would be tight.
What?
What?
That shit would be crazy.
I'm like thrown off.
I'm pleading the fifth on this one.
No, for real. What if you caught your mama twerking in for one of your homies?
Have you ever seen your mama do that?
Backstage at one of y'all concerts.
That shit would be crazy as hell.
That would be funny as fuck.
Think about it.
But I'm a girl. See, I'm going to think differently than what a son would think of his mom.
Man, I was taught early age, you don't be making no scene in public, so... Maybe when we get home, I might have to sit.
You gonna say something?
Corner.
So you ain't gonna say nothing to the guy. You just gonna sit there and watch or walk by and laugh.
Here we go again. This is two human beings doing what they wanna do. I ain't gonna interrupt that.
Wow. You gonna be like, Mom.
What if she's married to your dad?
I'm an all or nothing. So if I'm not able to kill somebody and get away with it, then we gotta let that shit slide. Talk about that shit another time.
Okay. Cool.
Okay. So, what would you do if you walked outside and you saw your ex-girlfriend slashing your tires?
Bitch, I got a restraining order. He's supposed to be 1,000 feet away from my house. That's what the fuck I'm saying. I don't know. Slashing the tires?
Yeah, your tires are done for.
New ones. I'm hitting up Big Sis on that one.
That's what's up.
Yeah, I'm hitting up Big Sis on that one. Fuck that.
So, do any you guys, y'all eat pussy?
I have before.
Come out.
Y'all have girlfriends, so I mean.
It's like a personal question.
Yeah, do y'all eat pussy? It's very personal.
It's very delicious too.
Yes.
Yes, he said it's very delicious.
Who said that?
Okay, so what if you were eating your girlfriend's pussy,
mm-hmm.
and she farted in your face?
Oh.
Y'all don't want to know my answer.
I do want to know your fucking answer.
So that must have happened to you before?
There might.
And you don't hear it, you smell it. It's a silent one, but it just creeps up in your nose while you eat a pussy.
There might be an accidental golden shower in the near future or some shit. I don't know.
Y'all can't pee when y'all hard, so no.
Yeah, that's for damn sure.
No, that tube is closed. We learned that in elementary school.
With the
so y'all pee when y'all hard?
The fart situation will get you left in the room real quick.
But what do you say? Like, because you don't hear, you smell it. That's it.
I'm just not saying a damn thing. She knows she did it. There's no talking with that.
It sneaked out.
Yeah, nah, hell no. Yeah, something going to
sneak. So if y'all was fucking, right, and y'all was fucking doggy style, and you know, sometimes y'all be like gonna go hard
in the paint,
and all of our stuff is connected down there. What if you like fucking her so hard and you push out a fart in her? Do you get mad? And you hear this one?
Okay, nah. That's
you hear it and it stink.
That's
and she bent over.
You use that as a man. You use that as an intermission. Get your stamina up. Go crack that window real quick.
Intermission
right there.
Like we're at a concert.
Yeah.
This is gonna be the intermission.
You want to fart, so that's your consequence.
You pushed it out of her though.
Hold that shit.
Hold your vibe.
Yeah,
hold
bye.
Hell, nigga, it's so I'm the fuck
this,
down back there.
I'm holding this nut in. Hold your fart in.
Okay.
Okay, last one. What would you guys do if you were out with your girlfriend and you see her? She's trying to be secret, though. Pick her nose and she eats it. What would you do?
Eats it?
Oh, no.
Hell no. That's a deal breaker for me.
What do you say, though? What do you do?
What the fuck are you doing?
Do you say something?
What the fuck are you doing?
Yeah. So, like, that's deal breaker. Like, it's over. You want to leave her there?
In public? Hell no.
Well, she was trying to be, you know, discreet.
If she
ate it, that ain't discreet. That's nasty.
That's disgusting.
If she picking her nose and eating it in the daytime, she picking her ass at night. Guarantee. She's all up in there at night by herself.
And
that's nasty.
First of all,
self-sufficient buyer.
Saving on meals.
No, you don't. Far out.
That's your food for later.
All right, well, you guys have made it through the get down.
Round of applause.
Hey. So, you're not any Mitches. Good for you guys. We don't have to blast y'all.
Right.
I'm talking about.
Why don't you go ahead and plug yourselves again and your social media and what you got going on one last time.
Once again, this is High Class Music Group, Mike Donatello.
Brandon Vader.
Once again, we got tickets to the Observatory Monday, November 24th. Make sure y'all go to HICMG.com to go get those tickets and everything else High Class Music Group.
HighClassMusicGroup.com. And like I said, follow us on Instagram and just keep up with us. We moving.
Observatory on Monday. We there live.
That's right. Fuck with him. All right, let's go ahead and get our shameless plugs in before you get up out of here. Once again, I am none other than Pretty Ricky, and I hold the keys to Yo City, Yo City, and Yo City. City. Hey. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Vine, and Shot at Pretty Ricky, RICCI.
And I am Nene Nice, and I'm like fire and ice. You can follow me at Nene Nice, NaeNaeNice, Twitter, Instagram, Vine, Shots, and Christian Mingle.
Bye. DJ Punch, our DJ.
Christian.
Follow me at I am DJ Punch on Instagram and Twitter. And then if you want to hit me up on Facebook, just look up DJ Punch, and I'll be right there.
All right. And our far out crew, half of it.
Boo-boo.
Miss Erica.
Hey, so you can follow me on Instagram, Miss Erica, MissAirica. Hey.
And our producer extraordinaire, DJ Rock.
Rock the guy.
Ready to say the thing. You can follow me, IB DJ Rock, at Instagram and Radio Free Rock at KJLisRadio.com and Facebook.
So no more Magnum in your life?
Nah,
no
you made more. Me. I, Yeah,
Rock, I got a big cock.
It's done.
You can follow our entire show at the Get Down _ on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Vine soon, Shots soon. But we have a lot of stuff going on. You may want to click that follow button. Shout out to Jay Hustle and Hustle Management for managing the Get Down, of course. Shout out to our intern, A. Nicole.
Shout out to Hustle's mom because it's her birthday. Happy birthday. Woo.
Shout out to Armadale Vodka, living that top shelf life.
Yes.
Shout out to Pitbull Energy Drink for sponsoring the Get Down every Wednesday night, 10 p.m. And, yeah, shout out to you guys for watching and listening every Wednesday. We love you all. Until next Wednesday, 10 p.m., the Get Down on RMCOnAir.com.
Tipsy, a little blunt, I pulled up in the S behind it. Fucked up, feeling all up on it. You know what I came to do. You know what I came to do. You know what I came to do. You know what I, oh. You know what I came to do. You know what I came to do. You know what I came to do. You know. Tipsy, a little blunt, I pulled up in the S behind it. Fucked up, feeling all up on it. You know what I came to do. You know what I came to do. You know what I came to do. You know what I, oh. You know what I came to do. 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 You know.
Ya acondiciona el programa del arranque, seguramente Pereira.
Muchachos.